Hello students, I hope all of you are doing well. I am Mohammad Yunus Sarwan, lecturer, Mechanical Department, Anjuman Polytechnic, Hubli. So in previous classes, we have been discussing about various type of machine tools like lathe machines, drilling machines, milling machines. Today in this session, we are going to study a new type of machine, that is reciprocating machine tools. Okay, let us begin. So each machine tool has its unique way of operation and specific use. Like that, this reciprocating machine tool also has its unique type of mechanism and specific applications. So what happened in reciprocating machines? The machining is achieved on the workpiece with help of reciprocating single point cutting tools. You may heard the term reciprocating motion. That is a backward and back and forth movement of the cutting tool. Okay. In this type of reciprocating machine, we classify into three types. That is shaper machines, planar machines and slotter machines. So let us start one by one. Shaper machines. These are the type of reciprocating machines used to produce the flat surfaces on horizontal, vertical and inclined planes. Okay. So in that shaper machines, we have situated one single point cutting tools on the ram head. So ram is reciprocating on horizontal axis. Keep in mind, only at the forward stroke cutting process is done. Okay, so that's why we are calling it is a cutting stroke. During the return of the stroke, there is no cutting operation. That's why we calling it is an idle stroke. And also one thing you have to keep in your mind, the speed of cutting at the forward stroke is slow as compared to the return stroke. Okay, this type of motion we usually known as a quick return mechanism. Okay, so this is the shaper machine. Let us discuss important parts. Here we have a base. Every machine tool's base is made up of cast iron to withstand the heavy loads and vibrations. And we have a ram. Okay, this is a ram part which is reciprocating horizontally. Okay, horizontally. And here we, on the tool post, we fix a single point cutting tool. And here in this table, we fix a workpiece. And observe here, we have an elevating screw. No, elevating screw is used to fix the table at any position. Okay, by this we can fix the workpiece at the any position of the any position. Okay, so next, so we can classify the various type of shaper tools on the basis of mechanism that we are going to use, and the position and travel of the ram, on the basis of design of table and the type of cutting stroke. Okay, here we have a list of different type of shaper machines. First, according to the type of mechanism, what mechanism we are using on the shaper machine, on that basis we can classify crank type, gear type and hydraulic type. And next, classification on the basis of position and travel of the ram. Usually ram travels on the horizontal axis, and thus we have a horizontal type of shaper machines. Sometimes the ram travels on the vertical axis, that's why we have a vertical type of shaper machines. And traveling head, this is in that shaper machine we can move the single point cutting tool into different directions. Okay, next, according to the design of table, we can classify into two types, that is standard shaper and universal shaper. Standard means we can fix only standard type of workpieces on this standard type of shaper machine. And universal means we can fix any size of workpieces, minimum to maximum. So that's why we call it as a universal shaper machine. Next, according to the type of cutting stroke, we can classify into two types, that is push type and draw type. Okay, here in this chapter we are concentrating on this type of classification, that is crank type and gear type and hydraulic type. Okay, in crank type we are using a mechanical elements, crank type. And next, in gear type we are using a rack and pinion mechanism to achieve the reciprocating motion. Next, in hydraulic type we are using hydraulic energy to produce the reciprocating motion on the ram. Okay, next. So every machine has its own specification. On that basis, we are going to choose the machine for the machining operations. Here we have some specification of shaper machine. we can specify the machine on the basis of length of stroke, how much stroke it will be produced. Okay, next, size of cube, that means the workpiece we can withstand on the work table, on the basis of type of drive, whether it is a belt drive or gear drive, and power input, power input, how much power we can supply to this machine. And next, maximum horizontal and vertical travel of the table. We already saw in the figure, we can fix the table of the shaper machine into vertical and horizontal direction. On that basis, we can specify the shaper machine on the basis of horizontal and vertical travel of the table. Next, cutting to return stroke ratio. We already know there are two type of stroke, forward stroke and return stroke. On that ratio of the stroke, we can specify the shaper machine. Next, number and amount of feeds. How much feeds we can give at our time? We on the that basis we classify the shaper machine. Next, to achieve a reciprocating motion, we have to use some mechanism. So here we have a mainly three type of mechanism to produce a reciprocating motion. That is, first one is crank and slotted link mechanism. Next, Whitworth quick return mechanism. Next, hydraulic shaper mechanism. Okay, this is we are going to discuss one by one. So first one is crank and slotted link mechanism. So please observe the important parts of this mechanism. Here we have a large type of bull gear, okay, and we have a sliding block. In that sliding block we have a crank pin, okay, and this crank pin is attached to this rocker arm, also known as a slotted link. This slotted link is nothing but a rocker arm, okay. And this one side of this rocker arm is pivoted at the bottom, and another end is fixed to the ram. Okay, what happen in actually when we supply the power to this bull gear, this bull gear rotates uniform with a uniform speed. By this rotation, will create the rotation of this sliding block. That will result in the movement of this crank pin, which results in the movement of this rocker arm. That causes the horizontal back and forward movement of this ram. Okay, in nutshell we can say the rotary motion of this bull gear into converted into reciprocating motion of this ram. Now the another type of mechanism is Whitworth quick return mechanism. This kind of mechanism is invented by the person whose name is Whitworth. That's why we call it as a Whitworth quick return mechanism. So let us observe the figure. Here also we have a large type of bull gear, and we have a crank plate and connecting rod and ram. To understand this mechanism, you just imagine the forced mechanism of four stroke IC engine. That is in the vertical shape. That cylinder is in the vertical shape. If you tilt it to the horizontal, then this is a similar to your four stroke IC engine. So carefully observe this figure. We have a large type of bull gear, and crank plate is attached to the face of the bull gear. Okay, then crank plate is connected to this connecting rod. When we supply the power to this bull gear, then bull gear start rotating. With that rotation will create the rotation of crank plate. Okay, then crank plate rotation leads to the movement of this connecting rod to produce the reciprocating motion of the ram. With help of this, we achieve this machining operations. Okay, so in nutshell we can say the rotary motion of this crank plate is converted to the reciprocating motion of this ram with help of connecting rod. Okay, moving to the next, this is a hydraulic shaper mechanism. This is a quite different mechanism as compared to the previous two. What happened in that previous two mechanism, we have using mechanical elements, but in this mechanism we are using a hydraulic energy. So in this mechanism you have important parts like a oil reservoir, valve and valve chambers, ram, connecting rod, pistons and cutting tools. These are the important parts of the hydraulic shaper mechanism. What happen in operations when we supply high pressurized oil from this right side direction, this oil traveling this path and exerting pressure on this pistons. That piston move forward and that make a forward stroke on the ram. Okay, That means this is a forward stroke. In next type of stroke, that is return stroke, the oil from the entering from the left side, okay, the pressurized oil is entering from the left side, that will travel in this direction and exerting pressure on the piston from this direction, and piston moves to the backward, okay. Whatever the oil may be present in this chamber, that is released to the again reservoir with help of valves. So by this cyclic process we can achieve a forward and return stroke mechanism to produce a machining operation at the end. Okay, this is the hydraulic shaper mechanism. So these are the three important mechanism. They are very important as a point of your examination, so please be concentrate on these three. So and totally, what are the application of shaper machines? What type of operation we can done on this shaper machine? With help of shaper machine, we can produce a horizontal flat surfaces, vertical flat surfaces, or angular flat surfaces. Along that, the main important is to produce the slots, grooves, and keyways. So these are the main importance that we using to that we can take a use of shaper machines. Okay, so this is today's session. So please study well, be prepared, and stay home, stay safe. Thank you.